Hey y'all, hope you're all doing well. Hello. It's been a minute since I've been live on this channel. I thought I'd switch it up a bit. I've been going live a lot on Michelle After Dark. I thought I'd give this channel a little bit of attention. So I'm here live on Michelle Walks. And today we are talking about the disappearance of 22-year-old Riley Strain. This is Riley on your screen. And it's a really unfortunate case. Really sad. And I'm going to tell you where I'm at right from the jump. Right from the jump, I think he's in the river. All right? You can come at me. If you think there's something conspiratorial going on, you can feel free to come at me. But that's where I'm at. I hope I'm wrong. I really, really hope I'm wrong. It's a 22-year-old young man who went out with his fraternity brothers in Nashville, and he never went home. So we're going to start from the beginning. This is a new case. This has been getting a little bit of attention over the last couple of days, but this happened on Friday. So he went missing on Friday. It was reported missing on Saturday. So this case has got quite a lot of information that's come out. I think that's why people are starting to pick up on it now, because the police in Nashville have released surveillance video. They've also released a 911 call, and the family have come out and spoken as well. So it's got pretty much everything that we would like in a case, you know, at least in the initial stages. So I'll give it a couple of minutes, just because I only gave people like 15 minutes notice that this live was happening. So we'll give it a minute. I know a lot of people don't like it, but I'm going to say a few hellos just to pass the time, you know, while people come in. Hello, Twisted. Hello. Hap Happy. This is your sister's neighbor's son's friend. I have to get my head around that one. Sister's neighbor's son's friend. Got it. All right, cool. Hi, Dorothy. Not familiar with the case? Well, we'll start right from the very beginning. We're going to start right from the very beginning anyway. Stepped onto a zebra crossing, said Pinchot, and disappeared. Yeah, because there's a big-ass river right there. Big-ass river right there. So nobody just disappears off the face of the earth. Everybody goes somewhere. Unfortunately, not everybody comes back from that somewhere. Hi, Jackie, Luna, Pam, Purple Lady, Kelly, Rhonda, Joanne, Egget. Jadzia, Jada, or Jaina. I really need to get my eyes tested. They're going worse, honestly. RZTV, hello, sweet peas. What else have we got? Golden, Kasha, Jean, Thunderhorse. He looks disoriented. He is very wasted. Very wasted. Yeah. Bama Cat, Debbie, Morgan. I think that's it. All right. I think there's more, but no, there's not. We're at the bottom. All right, I'm going to start from the very beginning for people. And I'm going to read a news article. Then we're going to listen to a couple of short news clips to get the orientation of the location. And we'll watch some surveillance. We'll listen to the 911 call that his buddy made. And that'll be that, because it's a lot of information to come out in just a few days. So this is, it was Riley's buddies and him were out in Nashville, but they're actually from Missouri. They're University of Missouri students. Riley's family come from Springfield, Missouri. And they were out partying. So he's part of a fraternity. So they were out on some kind of like frat jolly, and it looks like they got very wasted very quickly. All right. I was young once. I'm going to tell you. I'm going to tell you that I've been kicked out of a bar more than once. More than once for being wasted. And it's simply because I can't take alcohol. I could not drink however hard I tried, I could not drink nearly as much as everybody else. And I always was the wasted one. And yet I'd had half as much as everybody else. I don't know. So I don't know, metabolism thing. So I've been kicked out of bars. I've done exactly what this young man has done, and I survived. So this is a really sad, really unfortunate case where it looks like something really unfortunate has befallen Riley. Debbie, thank you for the £5. Thank you, thank you. All right. So I'm going to start right from the beginning. This is Fox News. So police in Nashville are continuing their search for a missing University of Missouri student after he disappeared Friday night during a night out with friends. Metropolitan Nashville Police, and their number, if you've got a sighting, their number is scrolling across the bottom of the screen, and we'll continue to do so throughout this live stream. So Metropolitan Nashville Police released new surveillance video on Tuesday, so recently yesterday, showing Riley crossing a street in the downtown area just before 10 p.m., so Friday, March the 8th. Riley can be seen wearing the same black and brown shirt his friend last saw him wearing. Yeah, because he just got kicked out of a bar. He got kicked out of a bar for being too drunk, and therefore his friend knew exactly what he was wearing. Police told Fox 17 Nashville that Riley was reportedly kicked out of the Luke Bryan's Nashville bar Friday night. So he was kicked out by the security for being too drunk. I don't know whether he was causing a fuss. I don't know whether he's just being really loud or he was just rolling about and, you know, he'd been overserved and they needed to get him out because they're, you know, people, they're a liability. Protest, you literally get kicked out, as I've been more than once. Do they say where he went to college? Yeah, University of Missouri. University of Missouri, about 6 hours away. So this fraternity just decided to go to Nashville to party for the weekend. So his family are from Springfield, Missouri. He and his friends that he was out with come from the University of Missouri. They were in Nashville for a party, and Riley is drunk. He's out there in a city that he doesn't know on his own. And there's a big ass river running right the way through the middle of the city. Okay. So he got kicked out about 9:30, so quite early. Right. So I would imagine that those lads have been drinking probably since the afternoon. All right, and they were probably tanked up before they went out, and yeah, sadly. No one has been able to locate him or get in touch with him since. So he travelled to Nashville with his fraternity brothers for a convention, for a conference. In other words, a party weekend. He told his friends he'd walk back to their hotel, the Tempo by Hilton, about 5 blocks away. I think he went the wrong way. I think he went the wrong way. And maybe you'll agree, maybe you won't when I show you the map. And I think, well, right, I'm getting above myself. Let's just do the story, and then I'm going to show you and kind of tell you why I think what I think. So the bar staff felt he'd had too much to drink, according to his family. His stepfather, so Riley's stepfather, Chris Whitehead, I think it's pronounced, said there was no hostility. He was just too drunk, you know, and he was asked to leave. The bartender said he'd been overserved. He was trying to pay his tab. When he left the bar, however, he appeared to walk in the opposite direction of his hotel. He'd gone the wrong way. He turned right when he should have turned left. So when he left the bar, he appeared to walk in the opposite direction. His phone last pinged between 10 and 10:30 in the area of Public Square Park, located near the Sheriff's Office and the Cumberland River. Okay. His phone has not been active since. Probably because it's in the water. Police said they deployed a helicopter Tuesday morning to search the area where Riley was last seen, including the riverbank area. Detectives on the ground also searched to no avail. The investigation as to his whereabouts is active, said the police. So his stepdad, Chris, told Fox 17 that this whole ordeal is a nightmare. And his mother, Riley's a little bit of a mama's boy. His mother would get texts and calls from him like every day. So she's absolutely devastated. She's just totally gone to pieces. I mean, it's just horrible watching how upset she is, you know, trying to talk to the media. It's definitely the worst nightmare, said Chris. He talks to his mum 3 or 4 times a day. For him to go this long without talking is not normal by any means. So I think we can take off the table that he's run away of his own volition. I don't believe that at all. Right? If anybody thinks that, I've not seen anybody think that, but, you know, usually that's one option. I don't think that's the case. I really don't think that's the case. He'd actually spoken to his mother on FaceTime earlier that day, like saying that he was having a good time. So I don't think that's anything. TC Restaurant Group, owner and operator of Luke's 32 Bridge, where they were partying, released the following statement to Fox 17, stating that they are continuing to work closely with police. TC Restaurant Group, operator and owner of Luke's 32 Bridge, is continuing to work closely with the Metro Nashville Police Department to provide security camera footage and any other potentially helpful information to aid in the search for Riley Strain. Our thoughts are with his family and loved ones for his safe return. Now, let's be very clear. I don't think that the bar person who made him leave has done anything wrong. I don't think they've done anything wrong, because that's what they do, right? If you're too drunk, they don't want you on the premises. You're a liability to them. So it's bad for business. You're going to hurt yourself. You're going to hurt someone else. You're going to, I don't know, a lot of drunken people cause arguments and cause fights. They don't know that you're not going to kick off and cause a fight. So they just want you off the premises. What you do after that is your problem. All right. So I don't think the bar have done anything wrong. I know there's some criticism of the bar, but I don't know what else they could do. I mean, I don't know. They're not babysitters. Right. And this would have been, it's a busy Friday night, 9:30, you know, it's a long time to go in the night still. And somebody to be that drunk that early, you know, and he's a big lad. He's between 6'5" and 6'7". So he's probably towering over the guy who asked him to leave. So they're going to think, he's going to be able to look after himself, all right? He's going to be fine. He'll get himself a cab. He'll go back to his wherever he's staying, and he'll sleep it off. Are they not liable if they're the ones who overserved him? Well, we don't know whether there'll be nowhere to prove that he was overserved there. So, no. I mean, technically, yes. But if he'd, how can you possibly charge a bar with something like that? Because he might have already been on the verge of being drunk when he arrived. They might have only served him one drink. I mean, So I don't think the bar did anything wrong. I don't think the bar is liable. He's a grown-ass man. Yes, he's a young man, but he's still a grown-ass man. He's 6'7". Not that size should really mean anything, you know, but I know, look, you know. All right, so it's 6'7", weighs approximately 160 pounds, so very tall, but very slender. Dark blonde hair and blue eyes. He was last seen wearing a black and blue button-up shirt with black chest pockets, blue jeans, brown boots, and a black Apple Watch. Authorities are asking anyone who believes they may have seen him to call the Metropolitan Nashville Police Department at 615-862-8600. That's scrolling across the bottom of your screen, and they've not responded to calls to the media. So that's Luke Bryan's bar in downtown Nashville. Okay. So I'm going to just show you the map as to where he was, and then we'll have a look at a couple of news reports. So this is Luke's bar right here. So it's on the corner here of 3rd Avenue and whatever this is. So that's where he was at. And this is where he should have gone. So his hotel's here. Now it's done a big loop. It didn't need to do a big loop. It's just because I've got Gay Street in, just to remind me. But look, he should have gone right. No, left. He should have gone left. So it's a very, very short walk. 7 minutes. 0.5 miles. So this is the hotel. Woo, I'm on the roof. Well, that looks like a car park. But this is the location of the hotel, somewhere around here. All right. So he could either, let's get this back to north. He could either have come out of Luke's and gone left, an immediate left, and that would have taken him to his hotel, or he could have gone straight on for a block and then turn left. So he needed to turn left. He needed to turn left. Wasn't he with his buddies? Yes. Yes. Now, according to Riley's family, one of his buddies wanted to leave with him, and the bar person, the security guard, didn't let that friend leave immediately. And that's a bit strange. However, I've seen that a lot. I've got, back in the day, I had friends who worked in security. I've seen that a lot. And what they do is, if they kick someone out drunk, right, they don't know that this drunk guy is really the friend of the person who's trying to follow him out. So in a cack-handed way, they're actually trying to protect him. So it sounds strange that they wouldn't let his buddy leave, like, initially, but, you know, situations do happen where people get followed out of bars. And just how horrible would that bar person or security person have felt if, you know, that wasn't his buddy, that was somebody who had ill intentions towards him. So what they do is they space you leaving. So they'll say, hang back. You know, you can go in 5 minutes, hang back. And they'd have stalled him, his buddy, for about 5 minutes or whatever. And then his buddy went out to see if Riley was there, and Riley wasn't there. So the buddy just went back in the bar and just thought, oh, he's gone home. You know, he's gone back to the hotel. Why wouldn't you think that he's got, you know, look, it's that close. It's half a mile down the road. All he had to do was turn left. He just had to turn left. And it's right there. That's where it is. He just had to turn left. I'll go straight on for a block and then turn left. That's it. So his buddies would have just thought nothing of it. Nothing of it at all. So instead, however, he ended up, hold on, I've got to find it again now because I've taken it off. He ended up here on the corner of First Avenue and Gay Street. So Gay Street goes north and then round, and then kind of joins, First Avenue joins Gay Street. So the surveillance video that I'm going to show you in a minute, that's where it was. And show where the park is where it last pinged. Yes, I can. Let me remind myself. It's dead close to this area. All right. Public Square Park. Thank you, Lindsay, for the £5. Thank you. Yeah, like and share to get more coverage. Yeah. The more you like, the more YouTube will push this up into the algorithm. So it does help when there's these missing persons cases that are new. You know, all eyes need to be on Nashville right now. Just because I think that Riley's in the river doesn't mean to say that he's in the river. It's just the most obvious, you know, scenario. But might not be. You know, the police are saying that they don't believe that a crime has taken place. However, you know, more eyes as possible. Right, Public Square Park. Okay. I think it's that one. There it is. So his phone last pinged here. So what he's done is gone, instead of turning left, he's gone straight on. Instead of turning left, he had an option to turn left there. He could have turned left at any block and got to his hotel. He's gone straight on and he's took a right. He's took a right. So he's drunk. He's disoriented. This is what I'm like in a city. Listen, right. I remember one time, and this was in the middle of the afternoon. I had not touched a drop of alcohol. Anything, I swear to you. And I was in Manchester, which I know Manchester, and I just got turned around. It was busy. I don't like busy streets. And I was trying to find a particular building because I was at a conference. So I was staying over, like I was finding the conference place, like the building. And then I was going to go and drop my bags off at my hotel. And my friend, who wasn't at the conference, but we were just going to share a hotel room and go out on the piss. And then I was going to go to my conference in the morning, right? So that's what was going to happen. I ended up going there first, right? My friend was going to follow later. And I just got completely turned around. I got off the train and I just got completely turned around. And I rang my friend saying, you're not going to believe me, but I'm lost. And he was like, where are you? Manchester. How do you mean you're lost? He said, what street are you on? I said, I don't know. He said, well, look up the street signs on the buildings. What building are you next to? It was like this most painful conversation, because when I get turned around in a city, I hate it. I hate cities. I actually quite like Manchester, but as cities go, I just don't like them. You want to go and watch my video? It's on this channel still. Northerner Lost in London, I think it's called. Oh, dear. Dear. Anyway, so he's gone right when he should have gone left. I swear to you, that's what he's done. He's, instead of taking a left, he's carried on. And then he thought, hold on, where am I? Oh, I need to go this way. He's gone that way. Right. He thought, that doesn't look right. I'm in a park now. That doesn't look right. So he's carried on walking and he's carried on walking. He's crossed this and he's gone up here. And there he is. That's where the surveillance video catches him. He's literally gone the wrong way. All right. So I'm going to play you. Which one shall I play you first? I've got three short clips here. Let me just have a look. So that's the river search. That's the 911 call. Right. I'll play this one. All right. It's only a couple of minutes long. Okay, so this came out 8 hours ago now. So this is WKRN. I'll post all of these links in the description box after. All right, let me know that you can hear this okay. Turn the sound up a bit. Should be okay.
Searching for their college senior. He went missing after a night out on Lower Broadway. A fraternity trip to Nashville has one Missouri family desperately searching for their college senior. He went missing after a night out on Lower Broadway. Now, over the last day, we've received new surveillance videos. Investigators try to find where Riley Strain may be. Jaxie Pigeons live along the Cumberland River and takes us through the footage that leads up to the last moments his phone was pinging.
Well, Neil, on Tuesday morning, Metro Police released what is currently the last time Riley Strain is seen on camera. But new surveillance video released from a local business shows the moments that lead up to that point. So it all started around 9:40 that Friday night. Friends of Riley's tell authorities he was kicked out of Luke Bryan's bar on Broadway. From there, the newest footage from a downtown smoke and vape shop shows him at 9:45 off 2nd Avenue North in Church Street. You can see he takes a tumble, gets up, and keeps walking. He's seen there in the two-tone shirt. Next is a video released from Metro Police that's timestamped 2 minutes after that. Riley is seen crossing 1st Avenue North to Gay Street, just ahead of the Woodland Street Bridge. Now, his phone last pinged about 600 feet away from that on Gay Street near the James Robertson Parkway Bridge. So from Luke Bryan's bar on Broadway to where he was last caught on camera, he walked around 3/4 of a mile. So far, authorities have searched the area on foot, used drones, helicopters, and boats. At this time, they have no further evidence. 7 of Riley's family members came to Nashville from Springfield, Missouri, in hopes of finding him. They say it's hard to wrap their minds around Riley disappearing, but they say they're keeping the faith.
I love you so much. We're trying to learn to find you. I love you, buddy.
We just want you to know we're not giving up on you. We're here waiting on you. I'll take you home.
Now, this is an ongoing investigation. If you do know where Riley is or know where he may be, you're asked to contact Metro Police. Of course, we'll keep you updated as we learn more throughout the day. For now, live in downtown Nashville, Jaxie Pigeon, News 2.
So they gave quite a good summary of the security stuff and where he's from.
Street near the James Robertson Parkway Bridge.
Okay, so let's look at this. So Luke's is here. Spotted on surveillance here, so he's gone right instead of going. He should have gone left, right? So he's gone right, spotted on surveillance, phone last pinged in the park, and then he's like here, this area. So it's all in a very condensed kind of space, but very sad. So let's watch that last surveillance again. And I'm going to stop it and slow it down. That's not it. There's my live link. There it is. Okay. All right. So there's a van that crosses up. So we've got, it's the corner of 1st Avenue and Gay Street. Okay. So there's the river. So this is the last point that he's caught on surveillance. So his phone's already pinged. This is him the very last moment of him being somewhere. All right. So just to remind you where this is on the map. All right. So park's there. And then we've got Gay Street, which is here, and First Avenue. So he's on this area here. So he's crossing First Avenue by the looks of things. Might be going that way, actually, but he's crossing here. So that's the location. And the river is right there. Let's go down to look at the river. Because it's not a little stream, this. It's a big ass river. Now you can't quite see, some of it's buried off, but there's, if you look from the opposite bank, it's pretty steep. So you can see there's the road curving round. Now there's like a parking area there, and you can see how steep that bank is. Now it is barriered off, but it does look like, at least on some of the news pieces where they've got the, you know, the news anchors standing by the river, it does look like the barriers are actually pretty small. So you've got to remember also that he's 6'7". And if he's completely disoriented, he's not going to be able to see this river. He's not going to be able to see this river from here. So remember, he's crossing here. He doesn't know this area, right? The river is down, like, it's a steep banking. And it's nighttime. What colour does water look at night? Black. Okay. So he might have thought he's going the right way. He's confused. He's going the right way. That's what he thinks. Because he now sees this curvy bit and thinks, oh, okay. He realises he's going the wrong way. And he thinks, I don't recognise this. I've gone through this part that I didn't recognise. And we don't know where they'd been earlier on. So it might not have been that they've come straight from the hotel down the road to Luke's bar. They might have gone all round the shop. He might have been, you know, just following his friends, and he's got, now he's worse for wear, he's on his own, he's in a city that he doesn't know, and he's thinking, I'm sure I'm going the right way. No, I'm not. No, I'm not. Hold on a minute. I think this looks familiar. I'll just jump over this fence. And he's down the bank and in the river. Simple, you know, just really sad, really unfortunate. It does look like it's barriered. But you've got a place there that doesn't look barriered. No. The fence there. You know, you do stupid things when you're drunk. You do stupid things when you're drunk. All right. Now, let's watch this surveillance in slow motion. So you will see a van coming along here, and then you see a group of people, and he's walking with this group of people, but he's not with them, He's just crossing with them, right? So here comes the van. This is Luke. This is Riley. Keep calling him Luke because it's Luke's bar. So there he is. So you can tell he's not with them, Like, those two went that way. These are carrying on walking. And he's a little bit kind of away from them. So it's not like he's joined a group of people. He's just probably just following... Thinking, I don't know what I'm doing. Now, this to me is very telling. Watch what he does here. So he's looking at his phone. Look, he stops. He's got his phone in his hand. Not on the phone. He stops. He's stumbling. He's looking round. He's lost. I bet you any money he's got maps up on his phone. I bet he's got maps up on his phone. And he's thinking, you know, and you, when you're drunk, you're like, oh, yeah, all right, I'm gonna go this way. And sometimes, you know, you get that little dot on Google Maps. And sometimes you have to walk a little way before you realize that you're going the wrong way. And then you have to go back. So he's drunk, but he's lost. I know this behavior. This is me in a city. This is exactly me in a city. I stop at a junction and I'm like, all right, I've looked at my map and I'm going to go this way. And then I try to be clever, thinking, all right, well, the map's telling me to go this way. However, I think this way is shorter. And then you get more lost. You get more lost. So watch him again. Watch him. So this is him here. So he stumbles. They look at him. He does a full 360. He has his phone in his hand and he walks off this way. I bet you he doesn't even know the name of his hotel. I mean, maybe he does. He's probably got his hotel, like, you know, with his destination, and he's just disoriented. And he thinks, oh, well, I'm going to try this way. And he probably realizes that his dot's going in the wrong direction because he should be going this way. He should be this way. He's going the wrong way. So he stumbles, stops. He's got his phone. Does a 360 and then just carries on walking in the same way. And he probably thinks, all right, it'll be right. And he's heading in the direction of the river. Sadly. So let's play the 911 call next. I've got this 911 call, and then I've got a little bit about the search. Okay. So this is his friend calling. Now, they wait till the Saturday, right? So they're probably thinking, oh, he's gone and slept it off somewhere. And then they've all gone to bed. You know, they've probably been partying until the, you know, early hours of the morning. They've all gone to bed. They wake up and they realize that Riley's still not there. So they end up then having to call the cops. So this is the conversation.
And the sheriff's office said that.
Saturday, March 9, 2020, 4, 13, 40, 6, and 24 seconds.
911, what is the address of your emergency?
Hi, I don't have an address. I'm trying to file a missing persons report, and the police. The central police is closed, and the sheriff's office said that we couldn't do it there.
Okay, so where exactly are you now?
We're in front of the Central Police, precinct. The Central Police Precinct on...
Okay, there, 601 Korean Veterans Boulevard in downtown Nashville, like right across from the Music City Center?
Yeah.
Okay, and is that where you're able to wait for a police officer to come and speak to you?
Yeah, we can wait for an officer here.
Okay, what's the phone number you're calling from?
Of my phone?
Yes, in case we needed to reach you back, what is the best number to reach you at? And what is your name, sir?
Braden, B-R-A-Y-D-E-N.
And your last name?
B-A-L-T-Z.
Okay. And who is it that you're wanting to report as missing?
We're here on a fraternity formal trip. It's one of my good buddies.
Okay. What is his name?
His name is Riley Strain. Riley R-I-L-E-Y, Strain, S-T-R-A-I-N.
Okay. Is he white, black, Hispanic, Asian?
He's white. 22-year-old, 6'5", blonde.
Okay. And what was he last seen wearing?
Outside of Luke Bryan's bar last night at like 10, and then the last time his location on his phone was by the sheriff's office. At like 11 p.m.
Okay, and what color clothing was he last seen wearing?
He's wearing jeans, boots, and a half black shirt, half brown, light brown.
Okay, and you said it last showed outside the sheriff's department?
Like around that area, by the river, by the sheriff's department over there.
Okay. Does he have any life-sustaining medications or disabilities?
No.
And you said he has a phone, so it's a cell phone, right?
Yeah, it's an iPhone 15 Pro Max.
What is the number?
But it's hold on. Give me 1 second. I got you.
Sure.
All right, are you ready?
Yes, go ahead.
Okay.
You said the last four were 4198?
Yes.
Okay. And are you going to be waiting there at the door of the precinct? Are you going to be waiting in your car?
I mean, yeah, we're at the front door of the precinct.
Okay. I've got the call sent there at the Central Precinct, 601 Korean Veterans Boulevard in downtown, right across the Music City Center. We'll get an officer out to you as soon as we can. Please call us back if something changes before they arrive. Sorry.
No, you're good.
Okay. Like I say, just call us back if something changes before they arrive.
That's fine.
All right.
We'll be here.
Thank you.
Okay, so that's the 911 call. So that's his friend, Braden, I think his name is, who made the 911 call. They went to the police precinct and couldn't get in and went to the sheriff's department and whatever. They ended up having to call 911. So very helpful, gave a good description of him. That was what he was wearing. So this is, we believe, exactly what he was wearing. So white, kind of half and half front, brown and white, and then it's got like a brown pocket, jeans and boots. So you can see exactly what he's wearing on the surveillance. And that's probably even taken on that day. I don't know. So, yeah, but they went back to the hotel, slept off whatever drinking they'd done, realized Riley was not with them. They pinged his phone. They actually, I think they looked at his location on Snapchat or something. They did something and found where his phone had been. And then the last ping was at the park area. So, sadly, the search is concentrating around the river. Perhaps quite unsurprisingly, because it's a big ass river. So that's the crossing area where he was, around here, this junction here. And the river is right there. So this is the Cumberland River. So I don't know where that goes. What direction is it flowing in? Where does it go? Anyway, I don't guess it matters. But yeah, so the last news piece that I've got for you is this one. So this is from 16 hours ago. So they were searching the river like all yesterday, 16 hours ago. So this is News Channel 5. All right, so I'm going to play this. This is nearly 3 minutes.
Tonight, a desperate search continues for a college student visiting Nashville over the weekend who just disappeared. No one has seen or heard from Riley Strain for 4 days now. Hi, everyone. I'm Rory Johnston. We've been in constant communication with Metro Police as they work to find the 22-year-old. News Channel 5's Hunter Hoagland talked with Riley's family. This as new clues might help investigators narrow the search.
Yeah, I'm standing in the spot where Riley Strain was last seen. He was picked up on surveillance video walking across this crosswalk Friday night. And what made it so hard for me to watch was that you could tell he was headed directly towards the Cumberland River. We so badly want Riley to be found, which is why we are showing you these two new pieces of video here tonight. Take a look. That's Riley Strain there in the two-tone shirt crossing First Avenue onto Gay Street. It was captured Friday night at 9:47, just 6 minutes before his phone went silent.
We talk every day, multiple times a day. And this is the longest I've ever gone without talking to him. It's devastating. I just want to find him and hug him.
We know from his parents and police that Riley was drinking with friends at Luke Bryan's bar on Broadway when he was kicked out. His parents tell me he was in town with 50 of his fraternity brothers from Mizzou. Not one of them left the bar with Riley to make sure he was okay.
I'm not gonna lie, it's a little hard to know that somebody didn't go with or, you know, whatever.
We obtained exclusive video showing the moments after he left the bar. Security cameras picked up the 22-year-old on Church Street before crossing First Avenue. He appears to be stumbling down the sidewalk as he heads into this camera here, just yards away from the Cumberland River. Police sent search crews into the water Tuesday, trying to find any sign of the missing senior from Mizzou. But with four nights of no answers, his family is just hoping he's alive.
Please help. If anybody knows anything, please call the police. Please.
Anything,
even if it's small, please just call the police.
A tough interview to listen to there. Friends and family are holding a prayer vigil tomorrow in Springfield, Missouri, praying that Riley is found. We want that too. If you have any information or video showing where Riley went, you're asked to call police. In Nashville tonight, I'm Hunter Hoagland. Rory, back to you.
Thank you, Hunter. Again, Riley should be easy to spot. He is 6'7" tall. He has light brown to blonde hair and blue eyes. We did reach out to Luke Bryan's bar on Broadway for a comment, but so far we haven't heard back.
Okay, so that's pretty much all we know for now on this sad case. So I'm going to play this once more. This surveillance. This is the last piece of surveillance video. So you can see he's walking on his own. He's going to come in a minute. So after this van, you've got a couple walking, then you've got a small group of friends. He walks out first. So So you've got those three, four, and you've got that couple. So they all walk across together, but he's not with them. They all walk off. He's not with them. He stumbles. He's got his phone in his hand. I think, personally, he's looking at his maps. He does a 360. Wait, one more time. And the river is right there. I mean, though, it doesn't even look like there's any barrier, but there might be. So there he is. Stumbles there. Stumbles again. Does a 360 and just carries on walking. Going in the wrong direction. Going in the wrong direction, son. So once again, this is where that was. So it's the corner of First Avenue and Gay Street. His hotel is right down here. The bar he got kicked out of is here. If he'd have done a left or a straight, then a left, he'd have been right at his hotel. He's gone the wrong way. He's gone straight too far, and then he's gone right. He's gone right at this park, and he's carried on going. And he must have got it in his head that he has to go right. I've got to go right, 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 right. Instead, he should have been saying left, 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 left. And on there, you know, this is a steep bank. And that river would not have been visible. If you were right next to it, given that there's trees and the bank, that river would not have been visible. So if he thought, right, I've just got to go right. Oh, I'll just hop over this barrier because he's 6'7", so he can probably hop quite high over barriers. I've got a shortcut. I don't know. Yeah, it does. Alcohol does make you do stupid things. And I don't think he intentionally meant to fall in that river. But you don't just cross a road and disappear into thin air. You don't. The main search is, well, there's two strands of this search. The river, obviously, and also gathering as much surveillance. And I think the police they've probably got like a good, they know what track he's taken. Like I think there's three different bits of surveillance that they've got him on. They know what direction his phone went in. So they know where he was heading. It was just unfortunately in the wrong direction. Thank you, Purple AJ, for the $2. That's very kind of you. Thank you, thank you. River flows east to west, does it? All right. Okay. Not that it really matters. Hold on. Let's put this back to north. Oh, yeah. So it flows west. So that way. No. That's north. So yeah, it's flowing that way, isn't it? You see, we are a very watery country here in the UK, and you'd be just so many accidents happen in rivers and canals when people have been drinking. He's 22, low ball. People fall in canals. I've seen, like, out in Manchester, there's canals all over the city and people fall in. they get out, but, you know, unfortunately, when you've got a bank like that, it's a big-ass river. I imagine the current's pretty strong. And he'd have been in that river before he'd even realised. So that's where I'm at with this case. I hope I'm wrong. Seriously hope I'm wrong. So let's give you the description of him again. So he's 22 years old. 6'7", well, between 6'5 and 6'7", 160 pounds. And that's what he was wearing. So it's like a light coloured half and half. So this is like black or dark brown. So quite distinctive. So if you saw him out last Friday, if you were in Nashville last Friday, you can't really miss him, can you? 6'7", wearing a distinctive shirt, and then blue jeans and boots. So he was kicked out the bar at 9:30. His phone pinged around 10-ish, half 10. And then his phone has just been off ever since. So the things I don't think happened, I don't think he wandered off of his own volition to start a new life. I don't think he intentionally harmed himself. So the only two other alternatives are he accidentally fell in the river or had a, I mean, it's, look, it's a busy city. If he'd had an accident anywhere in that city, he'd have been found. You know, he's not like in the middle of nowhere, is he? He'd have been found. You know, if a car had knocked him over, there'd have been people that have been, look. If he's had an accident, the accident's in the river. The other alternative is a crime. The police don't believe that there's a crime. They've got him on surveillance, like, you know, walking towards the river, and then he just disappears. So, yeah, and the water's going to be cold, yeah. Yeah. It's really sad. Hope I'm wrong. But this was Friday. You know, you can imagine Friday into Saturday, oh, he's sleeping it off somewhere. And then you go Saturday into Sunday. No, you're not still sleeping something off, are you? No. All right, I'm going to keep this one quite short so it's watchable for those on the replay. So I'm going to call it a day here. Just continue to share Riley's details. So if you were in Nashville on Friday evening, and you saw him, and you believe you've got a sighting that's different than what the police already know, then the number to call is scrolling across the bottom of the screen. So it's Metro Nashville Police Department, 615-862-8600. All right. Thank you for joining me. Please do continue to share Riley's case. Hopefully we get some news soon on what happened to him. Thank you to the mods as always. Thank you to those that donated. And I will see you tomorrow. Bye, guys.